Hello, everyone, and welcome to You Decide Southern California 2014. I'm Tony McEwing. This is a show where you get to meet the politicians pushing for your support. Now, we're going to ask the candidates some questions, some of the questions we think you would ask about the issues that matter to you if you had a chance to talk to them. And then you decide if the person deserves your vote. Now, to question those on the hot seat on this edition of You Decide, we have Brian Calle, opinion editor with the Orange County Register, also with the OC Register, Joseph Perkins, and our guests on the show tonight, Elon Carr, who is a candidate for a congressional seat, I believe the 33rd congressional seat. Also joining us is Jeff Stone, who is running for the state senate in the 28th district, which includes, by the way, the Inland Empire. But on the hot seat first is Lorri Galloway. She's running in a three-way race for mayor of Anaheim against current mayor Tom Tate and council member Lucille Cream. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the hot seat. And we're going to let Brian kick things off with question number one.
Let's go right into it. Anaheim, economic engine of Orange County. But there's a lot of unrest there, and a lot of people think it's a corporate-run town, and the average worker doesn't have much of a voice there. How would you give a voice to the average worker in Anaheim?
Just by virtue of who I am and what I do, I'm positioned differently, and I think that Anaheim needs a different kind of leadership. The riots of 2012 are a chilling reminder of neighborhoods that are still besieged by the issues of crime and gangs
and
graffiti.
But wasn't the current mayor an advocate for the people who are rioting and their issues?
Yes, but he's not entrenched in the community nor engaged in the community as I have been all of my adult life.
How so?
I've been the executive director of a nonprofit agency that is deeply involved in the communities, most especially the disenfranchised and immigrant communities of the city.
But to Brian's point, how do you break away from the basic corporate structure of Anaheim? How do you do that? How do you not get caught up in that?
There needs to be a balance. We understand that the resort area is the economic engine, and truly it brings in a lot of dollars. But I believe in partnerships. There are ways that the business community can partner with nonprofits and partner with communities and the city to provide a synergy and to work to find a better life and better opportunities.
You mentioned working in partnership, business and local government. What about two major issues that are still pending? One being the convention center, the other being the new ballpark for the Angels.
Well, let's talk about the Angels. Mm-hmm. You know, I think there's common ground. The city of Anaheim loves baseball and wants to keep our team. And I absolutely believe that Artie Moreno wants to stay in Anaheim. He's said it many,
the
many
owner
times.
Of the Angels.
Yes, Arturo is the owner of the Angels, and I believe that he wants to stay. But we're in negotiations. When you're in negotiations, you don't have a deal yet. So we're far apart. We need to get together. Basically, the negotiations have stopped. My point is we need to start talking. We need to dialogue, and we need to get to that bottom line. And we'll get there.
Do you believe that the city has a role in subsidizing the team and the new stadium?
No, I don't.
Why not?
It's a private enterprise. I think it's strong enough on its own.
It brings money into the city.
At a certain point, but I still believe that private enterprise can afford to do well on its own.
What about the proposal by Mr. Moreno to develop that city-owned property around the stadium?
Yes, I don't want to debate the issues, and because that's part of the negotiations, but I do believe as the city of Anaheim, we talk to developers to develop land that we own. Right. Now, he could be just equally involved as any other developer who wants to develop the land, but it has to be advantageous for the city.
Let me bring up another issue that is huge in Anaheim, and it's the way the city elections are held, the electoral process. I think that is probably one of the major issues, and you have certainly the ACLU, which believes that the way elections are held, the at-large elections as opposed to district elections, has resulted in an underrepresentation of particularly minorities, Latinos in particular. Are you in favor of district-wide elections as opposed to at-large elections, the way they're held now?
Yes, I am in favor of district elections. With a city as large as Anaheim with 350,000 residents and 50 square miles, there are different issues from the East Hills to the West End. I believe that people would be better represented by district elections.
All right, Ms. Galloway, this is the point in the segment where you actually get 30 seconds to make any statement that you want about your candidacy or anything that you want to address that you think that we haven't covered in the Q&A. Are you ready?
Ready.
The floor is yours.
Ready. I just want to talk personally from the deepest part of my heart. I want to say that the primary reason that I'm running for mayor of the city of Anaheim is my heart of service, which reflects from what I do in life. I'm inspired by servant leadership, the kind of leadership that stands in the face of adversity, yet chooses to stand for those who can barely walk. In the world of politics where the acrimony is the norm rather than the exception, I will reach out to find that common ground and make things work.
Lorri Galloway, thanks so much. Appreciate you coming onto the show. And a lot of issues there in Anaheim that have to be addressed. And we'll see what happens come November. All right, up next on the hot seat, State Senate candidate Jeff Stone of Temecula. He calls the federal government's immigration policies unacceptable. You decide, Southern California 2014. We'll be back right after this.